Kay Van Damme is one of the very few non-Brazilian scientists to have studied the Lençóis Maranhenses in any depth. He's back now to study this special ecosystem during the most mysterious phase of its cycle, the dry season.
It is very important for a scientist that this is considered a national park because the Lençóis, like other areas in the world, are very attractive, very nice, and without a certain protection of the whole area, it could change very rapidly and it could become completely different.
The shortest route to the dunes is the beach along the Atlantic Ocean, the northern boundary of the park. Kay's expedition is heading for the mouth of the Rio Negro. This is the spot where the only river that still flows through the dunes during the dry season reaches the sea. The continuous running of water here has dug a deep trench in the sand. It's one of the few spots where the very particular geological structure of the park can be clearly seen.
The secret of the Lençóis lays under the sand. There is a layer of peat, there's a layer of turf, and there is a layer of clay on which the sand is deposited. These layers contain organic material from former vegetation that was here before the sand was deposited. And we can see the proof of this by the color of the sediment that is below. The Lençóis is geologically relatively young. Most of the sand that you see here was deposited between 15,000 and 4,000 years ago.
20,000 years ago, during the last glacial maximum, a large proportion of the planet's water was frozen in glaciers. The average sea level was from 80 to 100 meters lower than it is today. The sand, which had accumulated under the sea, was therefore exposed to the air. For thousands of years, the wind drove this sea sand at the continent until it totally covered the coastal areas and vegetation. The organic matter thus buried under the sand underwent a slow metamorphosis, finally forming the dark geological layers that we find under the dunes today.
The secret of the Lençóis lies in the fact that below the sand, which is permeable for water, there is a harder layer that keeps the water during the wet season. And then once it's full, this water will overflow in the deeper cuvettes, and these cuvettes are the pools in the Lençóis. There are thousands of small pools and lakes, but in a way we can consider this area as having one large lake. We cannot see the lake, it is under the sand, and it is actually the large phreatic water table that connects all these pools during the rainy season.
Few creatures still venture through the dunes during the dry season. This seemingly lost armadillo won't survive for long in the debilitating heat if it doesn't find some shelter. Finding creatures in the burning desert will be no easy task. Fortunately, Kay can count on Jolison, who comes originally from Baixada Grande, the park's other oasis.
I chose to do research in the Lençóis because it has some basic elements that appeal very much to a young biologist. One is the novelty. It is a region that is not very much studied. The second is the aesthetic value. It is a beautiful area to come and explore. And the third is to actually explore and look at animals that are relatively badly studied. So that appealed to me, but even after 18 years, the feeling is exactly the same coming back here.
We'll take the air temperature.
Wow, that's hot.
It really is very hot, 39 degrees Celsius.
vamos por aí?
Shall we go that way?
Okay, let's go.
When we look at a lake like this, one would not think it is a lake because everything is dried out. And here in the Lençois, the water dries out and then it comes back. So waters are very temporary and short-lived. It seems to be that there is no life in this place, not right now, but this is the wrong perception. Within a small piece of sediment, it's full of different animals and also plants that can be revived once water comes into contact. In changing environments such as these, animals have to adapt, and if they do not adapt, they will go extinct. So it is in environments such as the Lençois, where animals adapt quickly, both on a yearly basis, but also on a longer time scale.
Okay, I found a paninga.
That's great.
It's usually really hard to find one.
Pretty rare, huh?
Very rare.
It's magnificent.
It's a female. A young female.
How can you tell?
The coloring is a bit lighter. There are light ones and slightly darker ones.
So this turtle is an example of species that are adapted to this special environment, whereas in Europe we have species that are adapted to very cold winters, which is the harshest climate that we have, and animals go into hibernation to survive. In here, in tropical and arid ecosystems, animals can into estivation. They can reduce up to 90% of their metabolic activity on a cellular level, which means in this period for months they will not need food and they will go into a kind of sleep mode. The environment allows them to actually emerge again from the sand and come into a new freshly formed aquatic system.
The Belgian scientist's special area of expertise is cladocera, or water fleas, tiny crustaceans which form the basis of the food chain in the lakes. The samples he takes contain thousands of these water fleas, but the minuscule creatures are invisible to the naked eye. To see them at all, the scientist will at the very least need a magnifying glass. When the lakes of the Lençois Maranhenses dry up, life doesn't totally disappear. Many of the creatures, including the fish, lay eggs which are able to survive the dry conditions. Buried in the dehydrated sediment, these dormant eggs are resuscitated as soon as the water returns. And life returns to the lakes according to an astonishingly precise chronology. First there's the plankton, soon followed by water fleas, then the fish, and finally the frogs and turtles, which emerge from the sand in which they buried themselves. The food chain always reestablishes itself in the right order. If it didn't, the survival of all of these interdependent species would be at risk. It is now October. Just a few shallow ponds remain. And yet, despite the arid conditions all around, water is never far away. Only a few meters under the sand lies the Lençois Maranhenses' huge body of groundwater.